Hi there, I am Kamla-Kay with Kamla-Kay.com, and I am going to be showing you in this video how to take proper agency digitals, also known as Polaroids, when you are trying to submit to a modeling agency, or if you've already been signed to a modeling agency and they are requesting these things from you so that they can then submit you to a potential client. So first things first, when you are trying to take digitals or modeling Polaroids, you will need to make sure that you have your proper measurements first. So the first thing that an agency is going to want when it comes to your body measurements is your bust measurements. So I'm going to go around my body, so go around my back. Just make sure that when you're measuring yourself that this is straight across, that it's not falling down. Otherwise, you're going to get an accurate reading. So that is to get your bust measurements. Now, in order to get your waist measurements, you're going to want to go across the thinner part of your waist area. In many cases, for most people, this is right across the belly button area. Just going to go here and see whatever the final number is, that is going to give you your waist measurements. In order to get your hip measurements, I'm going to take the tape measurer. Find wherever the widest part is of my butt, go all the way around, and that is going to give me the measurements for my hip area. So we have bust, waist, and hips. Now, aside from getting your bust, waist, and hip measurements, you will want to make sure that you get your height, and that's very simple. All you're going to do is just stand against a flat wall, take a pencil, mark right above your head, and then take the tape measure, measure from the floor all the way up to where you had marked that line on the wall behind you. Now that we have accurate measurements for your body, we want to go ahead and get into taking the actual photos for the agency. But before you start taking your photos, here are some things to keep in mind. When you're taking digitals for a modeling agency, they do not want to see you with a face full of makeup, with false lashes, with lipstick, the whole nine yards. The agency wants to see you in your natural state. So try to avoid the makeup. If you do wear makeup, let's just say, you know, that day you happen to get a blemish or two and you want to just quickly put some small concealer over it, that's perfectly fine. Now, depending on what the agency has requested of you with your digitals, it's possible that they want to see your hair pulled back. So right now I have my hair just in little pigtails just so it is out of my face, or they may want to see you with your hair out. For someone like myself with curly hair, I want to make sure that the client is able to see what my hair would traditionally look like when I show up to set that day for work. So that's why, even though with my digitals that I sometimes make sure my hair is pulled back from my face, I also want to ensure that I do have digitals pictures in my portfolio as well that showcases my hair in the state that would potentially be what the client would see when I show up for work. So go ahead, take some of your digitals as well with your hair out. Just make sure that it's not completely blocking your face, that the client is able to see all of your features. So let's say that an agency wants you to do digitals, whether or not your hair is pulled back or your hair is out, just depending on what the agency wants. Also, keep in mind that you want to wear something that is fitted to your body. So as you can see, I am wearing just this tank top. You're more than welcome to wear just a solid black outfit. That always works. Now, in doing your digitals, if you do not have someone to help you take your digitals, I highly recommend that you invest in a Bluetooth clicker. That way, this can just connect to your phone, because it's perfectly fine for you to take these digitals with your cell phone if you do not have a professional camera. So the first shot that an agency is going to want is your headshot. So that's just right above your head until right below the bust area. Okay, so you're just gonna stand straight, get your shot. The next shot is often referred to as a three-quarter profile shot. We're gonna start here, slightly turn your body, and then what you want to do is make sure that you can still see this eye and then see part of your cheek. And then we're gonna do profile. The agency may also ask you to do a profile on the left side and the right side, so make sure you get both sides just in case. Now we're going to do a three-quarter body shot. Now, for your three-quarter body shot, this is when you're going to want to step back from your camera, and you're going to be taking a shot essentially from right above your knee to above your head. You want to first start by just giving straight shots, and then this is when you can also give various variations of your pose, slightly, nothing crazy. See see how I just did very small movements there, but it gave the client, the agency, an opportunity to see small body movements without me doing too much. So now that it's time to do your full body digitals, you want to make sure that you are wearing a pair of skinny heels that are either black or a pair that is nude. You want to do skinny heels because it just really helps to elongate your body and it's not distracting. You don't want anything that's too ornamental within your shoes. So go ahead and stick one of these on and then we're going to do full body. So once you've put on your heels and decided to switch up the hair just a little bit to just still show your authentic self, then you step all the way back, make sure that the camera is giving you a full body position, and then you do the same routine where you stand straight forward and then start to give some slight variations in your body movements just so the client can see you from different angles at full body. Again, don't do anything crazy such as the contorted poses or anything like that. Be natural, smile, don't smile, give a variation as well in your looks. In doing my digitals, I want to ensure that I have good lighting, especially if I have to take digitals in an area that's not very well lit, or if my agency requests for me to quickly send in digitals and it's nighttime. So I invested in a ring light to just give me additional lighting. There's also various kinds of other lighting that you can get on the internet. A ring light is under $100 and is definitely worth the investment with doing some kind of lighting to ensure that you get the best digitals possible if you do have to take them on your own at home. Okay, so what are the takeaways from this video? First, you want to make sure that you get your proper body measurements, bust, waist, and hips, and that you also know your height. Then you want to ensure that you're getting a head shot, three-quarter shot, full body shot, and then your side profiles as well, depending on the agency requirements. Be sure that you're wearing something that's form-fitting. Then you also want to make sure that you are showcasing your face. So whether or not you have your hair up or down, just make sure that it's not fully covering your face. You can always start with your hair completely pulled back and then as well give shots with your hair out as well. As always, the agency needs you to have good lighting, no distracting background, so a plain white, light colored wall is always best. Stay away from using filters. This is not the time for them. And make sure that you're not having a full face of makeup. All right, those are your tips on how to take proper modeling digitals / Polaroids for your modeling agency. Again, I am Kamla-Kay with Kamla-Kay.com, and I will see you on the next video of educational tips all about the modeling industry.